Let's start from Basit and come down this route.
I actually just wanted to add to what Olu had mentioned earlier about MVNOs.
Yeah.
What we see that's going to emerge pretty very soon are MVNO type operations, where it's going to actually drive collaboration. Because once you're able to adequately support your primary base, then you're going to have abundant space to actually bring other players' white label services on.
Mm-hmm.
And that's really what technology affords us. That's what Telco 2.0 does provide.
Mm-hmm.
Your ability to bundle on other services aside from what you are all about.
Yeah.
And that for me really is the opportunity that I believe that we need to focus on as new players, that we will actually focus on as new players. Creating that enrichment of a broadband across every touch point and being able to marry promise to the customer experience.
Okay.
And that's so important. That really for me is really the key differentiator of where I can boldly raise my hands up and say that I've actually enriched your lives through my services.
Mm-hmm.
I've transformed environments through the use of my services.
Mm-hmm.
And that really is where technology is moving towards.
Mm-hmm.
How the likes of myself and Francis and Olu, as well as TD, can actually sit together and build together services, which I might provide.
Okay. So you're talking about being this enabler then?
Absolutely.
Yes, that provides 5 years, what specific segment?
Well, not just public sector, also the private sector as well, banks.
Okay.
Again, I mentioned earlier, today banks actually want to provide their services on the go to cut their customers.
Yeah.
Their inability to do that has been poor availability of broadband services, the bandwidth that they require, that they rely upon.
Yeah.
Again, you've seen banks slowly evolving into telco multimedia type services, and you've seen telcos move swiftly down the road past banking and begin to go into other things because they have the base, they have the networks. Now, once you start looking beyond you wanting to compete and look more towards collaboration, then your ability to get there gets faster.
Yep.
But unfortunately, we're not there because we're still trying to fight for our own survival. So one of the things that we intend to change is bring on that real collaboration. How you and I can still be competitors, but really I can provide services to you and you will sell on my behalf and for an earning that we can share together. We already see it with network providers. We're coming, collaborating with technology, telco operators, providing managed services. We as telco organizations also start providing managed services to a lot of our competitors as well. And these are, for me, the innovative ways of how we will provide and show the uniqueness of Telco 2.0. I touch on the public services because I see a lot of the public services today, based on what currently prevails in the country, are cashless. Some of them are actually bankrupt. And some of them will need to rely more on technology to get out of that and become more enabling to provide the services that the environment they actually serve deserves. Hence the reason why I said that, look, through collaboration with a PPPP approach, we'll achieve a lot from my own perspective. And we'll achieve one of the key things of where I believe would develop the Nigerian community more, which is urbanization of rural communities. I mean, again, like I said, when you fly into the country or you fly into any parts of the country today, you see a lot of forest. That for me is a smarter cities waiting to evolve, markets waiting to evolve. And you fly into the UK, America, anywhere else, any of these major cities, you see big city showcases, you know, success stories. We need to get there. We ought to be there by now. So I do believe that Nigeria needs to move swiftly away from oil and gas. The new oil and gas is data. And we've got to build on it and transform it to what actually going to give us those sustainable economies. That's going to drive the new skills that I believe the Nigerian youth of today and tomorrow and the future deserves. Once we start developing things beyond our own lifetime, then we are there. And that's where I see where Telco 2 and the next Telco that zero is going to be all about. So that for me is my own parting words in saying that we've got to start building and mastering the basics before becoming innovative. That's my view, and that's what Ntel is really going to drive. We're going to change the way telco services and non-telco services are going to be consumed, provided, and supported across all business verticals.
Thank you.